Today, we're going to take a moment to talk about the importance of choosing the right surface finish to achieve product success, and also why it's critical to share this information with your supplier early in the design stages so they can help you get the best results to suit your application. Welcome to another episode of Factory Insights brought to you by Star Rapid, where we offer useful information from the shop floor that can help designers and engineers make smart decisions when developing new products. First, let's note that all manufactured products will, of course, have some kind of surface finish as a byproduct of whatever process was used to make them. That's inevitable, and sometimes an as-is surface is acceptable, while in other cases, some additional work is called for to achieve a more specific result. When we talk about surface finishing, we usually mean either applying a secondary coating like chrome plating or painting, or performing a mechanical treatment like sanding, blasting, or polishing, or even some combination of these. Whatever the treatment, finishes are designed to change a product's appearance and performance to match the application. To do this, you need to make sure that the desired surface finish and the underlying raw material are compatible, which is not always the case. After all, once production has begun, it may be too late to change your mind midway and apply a surface treatment to a material that it's unsuited for. An example of this might be deciding at the last minute to anodize AL775, not the ideal choice since AL6061 gives more stable results. Also, consider that every additional finishing step increases the cost of the finished product while also extending the production lead time. Remember, if you're making a product that relies on a family look as part of the brand image, then it's essential you choose both the materials and the processes in advance that will help you achieve it. Think matte silver gray aluminum for Apple Mac computers, or the highly saturated glossy primary colors of a Lego brick. In addition, bear in mind that rough or matte surfaces may look nice, but they also create more friction. That's why if your part needs to move or slide against something else, then a rough matte finish is not the way to go. It will show wear marks very clearly and may even fail prematurely. Polished surfaces slide better and they resist corrosion. However, it may take more expensive secondary polishing to achieve a smooth finish, and some materials take a polish better than others. Think chrome-plated stainless steel compared to galvanized zinc. We can't begin to cover all possible surface finishing variables in this brief overview, but what we can stress is that product developers need to design for surface finishes at the very start of the development process, and they should share their needs with their manufacturing partners who may be able to offer advice and insights to achieve product success. If they fail to do this, it may be impossible, or at least expensive and time-consuming, to make changes to a surface after it's already been processed. It might mean making a new plastic injection molding tool or adding an additional processing step that could have otherwise been avoided. We hope this information has been useful, and if so, then please consider dinging the bell, liking us, and subscribing. We'd also like to invite you to suggest some content that you would like us to cover in our next installment of Factory Insights.